Well, we had been number two for 852 weeks. 852 weeks. And on April 19th, we became number one for the first time in that length of time. And so I thought I would feel a certain way. But later that day, April 19th, the same day that we're number one, I was told I had 1 to 2 years to live. Can you imagine? You are, you know, sipping champagne with your colleagues in the morning, and by mid-afternoon, you're told you might not be here for another year or two. That is a reminder to me and for everyone. Oh, by the way, I'm still here. So they were wrong. So they were wrong. So that worked out really well for me.
Thanks for all of us.
But thanks to wonderful doctors, nurses, technicians, the good Lord, the prayers, and my sister's DNA. But the point being, we have an idea how we're going to feel once we land that big venture, once we start that company, once we get married, once we have children, once. And you realize that the destination is not what it's about, it's the journey. If you don't take the time to enjoy the journey. Life is a journey, it's not a destination. There are no mistakes, there's chances we've taken. Lay down your regrets because all we have is now. That's a lyric of a song that I wrote with India Arie after I went through breast cancer. Life continues after having these immense struggles. So that date, I had this wonderful picture of that day that our president, news president, Ben Sherwood gave us, and we're all like, ah, and it has April 19, 2012, and I look at that picture on my coffee table, and I don't see it the same way as everybody else does, but I love who's in that picture, but I love looking at it, and it is a stark reminder to enjoy the journey.